In this video, we'll look at the top 10 things to know in SPSS for beginners. Number 1, the variable view and data view tabs. So if you look down towards the bottom of the screen, you'll see two tabs, data view and variable view. And in this window here, we have the data view tab open as it has the gold background. And you can see here on your screen that we have a very small data set where we have a variable gender and a variable exam 1, which corresponds to the exam scores on the first exam for 10 different people. The names of these two tabs give a big clue as to their purpose. For example, if I want to create variables, like say that we want to create another variable scores on the second exam, so I might want to name this variable exam 2. If I want to create a variable, then I want to go to the variable view tab. And if I want to enter data or numbers, then I want to go to the data view tab. So if we want to create a variable exam 2, let's go ahead and go to the variable view tab. And then underneath exam 1 in row 3 here, I'll go ahead and click on this cell under name and type exam underscore 2. Now you could call it just exam 2 if you wanted to, but I like to have the underscore to make it stand out a little more. And then I'll press enter, and the values to the right fill in automatically. Now, we just created the variable exam 2, and now I want to go ahead and enter the values for exam 2. So to do that, I'll go to the data view tab, since now I'm going to enter the values or enter my data. So here, after I enter each score on the exam, I press the enter key, and that moves it down. Okay, so I've entered all those values for exam 2. So once again, when I want to enter data, I go to the data view tab. And when I want to create or modify a variable, I go to the variable view tab. Number 2, variable names, rules for naming. So when I name variables, there's a few rules I have to make sure I follow, otherwise I might run into trouble. And why don't we go ahead and break those rules to see what happens if we do. And one thing you cannot do is start a variable name with a number. So I'll just call this 2Test, just as an example. Press the Enter key. And notice I get an error message. Variable name contains an illegal first character. So I can't start a variable name with a number. But as you can see here, I can certainly use a number at the end of a variable name. But I just can't start a variable name with a number, otherwise I'll get an error message. Something else I cannot do, if I wanted to have, let's say, exam 3 here, I cannot have a space. Notice there's a space here in this naming. If I press enter, I get the error message again. It contains an illegal character. One other thing I want to stay away from is using special characters or symbols. So for example, exam asterisk 3, that's going to give me trouble as well. And something like an ampersand will do it too. Exam and 3, that gives me trouble as well. But I can name, I can use 3 at the end, that's fine. I can use 3 throughout, except as the first character, and that's fine too. For spaces, what I do, since we can't use them, I like to use those underscores, and that works fine. In summary, the three things we don't want to do is we don't want to start a variable with a number, we don't want to use any spaces, and we also don't want to use any special characters or symbols in naming our variables. I'll go ahead and delete these by grabbing the row headings here, clicking on the right mouse button, and selecting clear. Number 3, creating value labels. Now, if we go to our data view tab, and I look at my variable gender here, notice I have ones and twos. And the ones and twos differentiate between males and females. However, as my data set currently exists, it's not entered in here which gender is a one and which gender is a two. So I want to make sure I do that so that if I go back to this data set later, I'll remember females were a 2, for example. And there's another useful reason why I want to do that as well, and that is when I run analyses and get tables of output, if I don't have value labels, then I'll just get 1 and 2 reported. But if I do have value labels, then I'll get the labels I actually use reported, like male and female. And it just makes it a little bit easier when I read the output, and I'm less likely to make a mistake. So let's go ahead and see how to enter those value labels. So I'm going to work on that variable, so I'll go to the Variable View tab, and then under Gender, where it says Values, in this column here, I'll click on this cell, and notice here that the three dots appear. Go ahead and click on that, and then here we see Value Labels, and recall that I have values of 1 and 2. So under Value, I'm going to put the number, the first one, 1, and 1 corresponded to Male, so put Male for Label, and then click Add. And notice how it throws it down here, 1 equals male. And if 1's male, then 2 is female. So go ahead and enter that in. Click Add. And then once you see the labels down in the box here, go ahead and click OK. Okay, and that's it for creating value labels. Number 4, displaying value labels. So now that I enter the value labels, I can display them as male and female if I want in my spreadsheet here. And to do that, I want to go up here and click on this button, which is known as the Value Labels button. So go ahead and click on that. And then notice here, now we see male and female instead of 1 and 2. Now this is really just a cosmetic effect here. It's important to note that SPSS still records the 1s and 2s behind the scenes, and when we perform analyses, they're performed on the 1s and the 2s. This is just for our preference. If we like to see this here, then we can click on that Value Labels button to have them displayed. Notice how it appears that the Value Labels button is pressed in. So if I want to turn off those labels, I just go ahead and click on that button again, and then now you can see that they are in fact turned off. But once again, they're still in SPSS behind the scenes. And if I save this data file, come back to it later, they will still be there. I just have to click on this button. And if I run any analyses, they will be output in the results. So instead of 1 and 2, I'll have male and female labeled in my tables.